Let's talk about another company. That's Skipper. We have with us Sharan Bansal, the director of the company, who joins us on the phone line from Kolkata. Hi, Mr. Bansal. Thanks so much for joining in. Your BSP announcement says that there is some capacity that's come on stream. Could you give us some details? What kind of capacity utilization levels are you looking at for the next couple of months? And when can we see 100% capacity utilizations? Also, give us some guidance in terms of revenues that we're going to get from this added capacity.
Yeah, hi, Nigel. Yesterday, we inaugurated our Guwahati PVC plant. This is our third capacity for PVC products after Kolkata and Ahmedabad. And now the combined capacity of the company stands at 29,000 tons. This is in line with our overall capacity drive to take our capacity up to 100,000 tons over the next 4 years. And as I mentioned before, all of this capacity is being built on the asset-light model. In terms of utilization, till last year, we only had Kolkata capacity, which we had achieved full capacity, 100% utilization there. This year, because of the new plants coming up in four new locations, Ahmedabad and Guwahati, which have already started, and Hyderabad and Secunderabad, which are going to start in the later part of the year, we expect capacity utilization in the new plants to be, of course, lower in the first year. But by next year, they should be achieving close to 100% capacity utilization as well.
Okay. Can you tell us then, with your enhanced capacity, what would be the revenues of the company in FY16 as well as FY17? Because a couple of your other projects will come on stream only next year.
Yeah. So, in terms of the revenue growth in the PVC division, we are expecting a comfortable 100% growth in the revenue here. Our sales of last year, 100 crores, I think definitely we should be crossing, looking at 200 crore plus this year. I think that's going to be where we look at, close to 100% growth every year for the next 3 years here.
All right, one final question, Sharan, before we let you go. You know, there's so much of talk about anti-dumping duty coming in, maybe minimum support price, reserve price coming in for steel. You import, I think, long products. Have you factored any kind of negative impact if in case there is that minimum import price that comes in?
Not really, because our products are mostly long steel products, and the anti-dumping as of now has only been levied on certain classes of steel products. So that has no impact on our pricing, on our raw material pricing. And in fact, we don't expect at all government to levy any kind of anti-dumping products, because that has a direct bearing on construction and as well as inflation.
All right, Sharan, thanks so much for joining and detailing all those numbers. That's the management over there telling us that the PVC business will start contributing more in the times to go ahead. But time for a